Good morning to all students. Yesterday we have discussed about the started the chapter strategies of enhancement in food production, and then we discussed about the introduction of the animal husbandry, about the livestock. Then we have discussed about the dairy farm management and poultry farm management, right? Different precautions we have to take in that management. And then we have discussed about the breeding methods, animal breeding, two most important techniques for there, inbreeding and outbreeding. Inbreeding is a natural thing, outbreeding is a natural thing, but it is a hybridization technique which includes outcrossing, crossbreeding and interspecies breeding or interspecies hybridization. So we have studied with the respective examples. Now we'll move to the next topic. Today, one more important point is the controlled breeding methods. The next topic is controlled breeding methods. Thereafter, we have discussed about two most important industries, that is apiculture, the rearing of honeybees, and the fisheries, the rearing of fishes and other aquatic animals. So we'll start with the topic controlled breeding methods. Now, the controlled breeding methods are artificial methods. They are not natural. So they are performed in presence of experts in the laboratories. So it is called artificial methods. It includes two important things: artificial insemination, and the second is MOET, multiple ovule embryo transfer, MOET technology, multiple ovule embryo transfer. Now first we'll discuss about the artificial insemination. What is the artificial insemination? Okay, so here two important controlled breedings are there. Artificial insemination and multiple ovulation embryo transfer. Now what is artificial insemination? It involves insemination the native cows with the semen of superior bulls of exotic or indigenous breeds. Now what is insemination? Insemination refers to the deposition of sperms into the female reproductive tract with artificial means. Artificially हमें semen को या sperms को female के reproductive tract में release करना है. So that is called artificial insemination. Now in this, the native cows, the local cows are seminated with the superior bulls of exotic or indigenous breeds. That means exotic means apart from India, and indigenous means these are the hybrids produced in the India. So these are called indigenous breeds. So this is the technique of artificial insemination. Now what is the use of this artificial insemination? It helps to overcome several problems of natural mating, such as comparatively lesser amount of semen is required. Cows at distant place can also be fertilized. That means sometimes the fertility also gets reduced. Sperm count is also a problem, right? If the sperm count is problem, that means the semen consists not, the semen is not having an appropriate amount of sperm count, that is number of sperms. So there is a chance of failure of fertilization naturally. So in that case, we have to follow the artificial insemination. So this is the first technique. Now the second thing is MOET, multiple ovule embryo transfer. अब इसमें क्या हो रहा है? दो चीजें. First, multiple ovulation. Second is embryo transfer. Now what is multiple ovulation? Ovulation stands for releasing of ova from the ovary. It is called ovulation. Now in the case of humans, it occurs during the menstrual cycle. So here in every mammal, the number of ovules are very less. In case of cattle, it almost maximum one or two ovules released per ovulation. In case of cattle, maximum one or sometimes two ovules are released. So majority of one ovule only released. So if per menstrual cycle, if one ovule is released, the number of ovules are very less. But by this technique, we can produce number of progeny within a short period of time. That is multiple ovulation. Ab multiple ovulation ka matlab hai, per ovulation, more than 3 to 4 ovules are produced. That means 7 to 8 ovules are released per one ovulation. And it because of the artificial induction. Now, the whole process of ovulation is controlled by different hormones. Okay. Now, the first is ovules are developed in the ovaries, and these ovaries are matured because of the hormones released by pituitary gland, that is FSH and LH. We have discussed in the last year chemical control and integration chapter. So FSH and LH, follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. These two hormones are helps to induce the development of ovary and the ovulation. So artificially we are giving the huge dose of these hormones to the ovaries so that the ovary can release number of ovules per time. So we'll see here. So multiple ovule and embryo transfer. What are the steps? Cow is administrated with FSH like hormones, which includes follicular maturity and super ovulation. In super ovulation, instead of one egg per cycle, 6 to 8 eggs are produced per cycle. That is because of the high dose of FSH. So in normal ovulation, only one egg is released. So if instead of one egg, it's 6 to 8 eggs are produced, that is called super ovulation. And this super ovulation is administered with the help of FSH like hormones. Now, after ovulation, the cow is either naturally mated with superior bulls or artificially inseminated. If naturally mated or artificially inseminated, not difference at all. After mating or after artificially insemination, the zygotes are produced equal to the number of eggs. If the 6 to 8 eggs are there, then 6 to 8 zygotes are produced, and these 6 to 8 zygotes undergo cleavage to produce an embryo, which is approximately 8 to 32 cell stage. Now these fertilized eggs are, we can say, the embryonic stages. We have to remove from the cow by non-surgical methods and transfer to different surrogate mothers. अब एक cow में एक embryo develop हो सकता है, so बाकी के जो extra embryos हैं, हमें उनको उस cow के uterus में से निकालना है, and then we have to transfer these fertilized eggs, or we can say the embryos, to the surrogate mothers. Right? So the collection of these fertilized eggs or embryo should be between 8 to 32 cell stage. Zygote is a one cell, and once it starts the cleavage, after it attain 8 to 32 cell stage, in between any of the stage, we can collect these fertilized eggs or embryos and transfer to the surrogate mothers. Now the collection of this fertilized eggs should be non-surgical. Non-surgical methods means here one figure is given right side. It's a non-surgical collection of embryos using the gravity flow system. Two figures are given. One is a flow chart, how we can perform MOET. And the second is the collection of fertilized embryos or eggs. Now it is a collect, this is a non-surgical method. Yahan koi surgery nahi karne padegi. And it follows the gravity flow system. Yahan hame gravity ko istemal karke ek catheter, foley catheter, instrument ya device ka naam hai foley catheter. this Foley catheter inserted into the uterus through vagina where the embryos are there, and these embryos are collected by this catheter based on the gravity flow system. So there is no surgery is required. So it is, hence it is called non-surgical methods. Now this is the flow chart. First, the cow should be administered with FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, so that the follicles get matured inside the ovary, and then superovulation occurs. That means it produces 6 to 8 egg cells per cycle. Now these 6 to 8 eggs either mated with superior bull naturally, or we have to inseminate artificially. Because of this, the fertilization takes place. Now the embryos are recollected at 8 to 32 cell stage, and if necessary, they have to transfer to surrogate mothers, which helps to produce the hybrid, or we can preserve these fertilized eggs by cryopreservation method for further use. So cryopreservation means the preservation of eggs, embryos at -196 degrees centigrade in liquid nitrogen. That is called cryopreservation method. So this is called multiple ovulation and embryo transfer. The first half is we have to administer the cow with the hormones to obtain more number of ovules per ovulation. That is called multiple ovulation or super ovulation. And then after fertilization or artificial insemination, we have to collect all the fertilized eggs or embryos, and then we have to transfer to the surrogate mothers for further development, or we can store or preserve by cryopreservation method. So this is the multiple ovulation and embryo transfer technology. The genetic mother is available for another round of superovulation. That means once the recovery of unfertilized eggs over, then the genetical mother is again ready for the next super ovulation. By using this technique, high milk yielding breeds of females and meat yielding bulls have been bred successfully. So is method ke through hame jo required characters hai uske hisab se hum naye naye breeds ko ya high yielding milk producing females ko hum produce kar sakte. So this is about the artificial insemination and MOET, multiple ovulation and embryo transfer technology. And the collection of fertilized eggs should be by non-surgical method, by Foley's catheter device on the basis of gravity flow method. So this is about the animal breeding. Okay. Now to the next topic, apiculture and fisheries. Now before going to that, we have some different species names, breed names are there, which are most important for your examination, right? ये नाम आपको सभी याद रखने हैं. These are the some important breeds of various animals in India with their respective states. Cattles are there. Here some breed names are there. Gir, Sahiwal, Red Sindhi, Deoni, Malvi, Tharpakar. These are different breeds of cattle and their respective states. Gir is from Rajasthan and Gujarat. Sahiwal from Punjab and Haryana. Red Sindhi from Andhra Pradesh. Deoni from Andhra Pradesh. Malvi from Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. Tharpakar from Rajasthan and Gujarat. These are some of the breeds of cattles. Now the next are buffaloes. Murrah, Bhadwari, Jafarbadi, Surti, Mehsana, Nagpuri, Ilaichpuri, Nali Ravi. So these are our different breeds of buffaloes belongs to their respective states here. From Gujarat, we have Mehsana and Surti. Okay. So all these names you have to remind for your examination purpose. So these are the some of the breeds of cattle in India. Now these are some of the breeds of cattle from exotic, that is outside of the India. Jersey belongs to English Channel, island of Jersey. Holstein, Friesian, Holland. Ayrshire, Scotland. Brown Swiss belongs to Switzerland. Okay. Now, these are the some important chickens used in poultry industry. American breeds are there. English breeds are there. Asiatic breeds are there. Most of the belongs to India, and Mediterranean breeds are there. American breeds, Plymouth Rock, Wyandotte, Rhode Island Red, Jersey Black, Gaint, New Hampshire. English breeds, Australarp, Cornish, Dorking, Orpington, Sussex. Asiatic breeds में Brahma, Cochin, Langshan है. Mediterranean breeds में Leghorn, Minocqua and Angus. So these are all breeds of chicken. Some of important breeds of sheep. Nali and Shahabadi. Nali belongs to the Jammu and Kashmir, and Shahabadi belongs to Bihar. So these are all different breeds of chickens, cattle and sheep, right? So these are used in different parts of the world to produce very useful breeds and their improved progenies to obtain high quality of meat and milk with a proper quantity. So this is about the animal breeding, artificial and controlled breeding techniques. Now we'll move to the next topic, that is apiculture, that is called beekeeping. Economically most important industry, right? So we'll move to the apiculture. It is called beekeeping. It is a care and management of honeybees. The rearing, artificially rearing of honeybees is called beekeeping, and in the industry name is apiculture. Why apiculture? Because the genera name of bees is called Apis. Here some species are given. Apis dorseta. It's a rock bee, largest honeybee in the world. In terms of size, Apis dorseta is the largest bee, that is called rock bee. Apis indica. This species is belongs to India. That is why it is called Indian bee. Apis florea. It is the smallest bee with respect to the size. So it is called little bee. And Apis mellifera is an Italian bee. So all of them occur in nature as a wild insects. However, because of their high economic importance, the honeybees, especially Apis mellifera, is domesticated, reared and bred in artificial hives also. पूरे वर्ल्ड में आर्टिफिशियली रियरिंग होता है एपिस मिलिफेरा का, इटालियन बी का. इंडिया में हम एपिस इंडिका का इस्तेमाल करते हैं. नाउ द हनीबीज आर दीस डेज रेज्ड इन अ स्पेशल बॉक्सेस कॉल्ड एपियरीज और एपियरी. इट इज द प्लेस वेयर बीज आर कल्चर्ड एंड ब्रेड टू गेट कमर्शियल प्रोडक्ट्स. So, Apis indica is a Indian honeybee, and Apis mellifera is cultured in the world artificial. Now here, one picture, three pictures are there here. The first box is there. This is the apiary. This is a box. Inside the box, there are so many blocks are there in which the trays are kept. And this is the tray where a wax layer is there, and on this wax layer these honeybees are reared. Okay, so this is the apiaries. It's a box used in apiculture industries, right? So what is the use of apiculture? There are so many economic importance are there. Honey has a high nutritive value and medicinal value, as we all know. Honeybees also produce bee wax that is used in preparation of polishes and cosmetics industry. Most commonly reared species of honeybee is Apis indica in the India. But in case of, apart from India, Apis mellifera is used. Now, apart from these benefits, most important benefit of honeybees is pollination. Keeping beehives in a crop field such as sunflower, brassica, apple and pear during flowering period increase the rate of pollination and it improves the yield of that particular crop. So, here two benefits are there. It is kind of a symbiosis again. Plants and honeybees are living together. We already discussed in the 13th chapter when we have discussed about the different population interactions, right? So honeybees are most important for pollination. So like some sunflower, brassica, apple and pear, these are the some crop fields in which if we kept the apiaries, that is the boxes of beehives, the bees pollinate all these plants, and by pollinating they will benefited with the nectar from the flower. So by taking nectar, the yield of honey also increased, and because of the pollination, the productivity of the plants also get increased. So this is the most important benefit of apiculture. Okay. Now, beekeeping is not a labor intensive. इसके बहुत सारे फायदे हैं और ये बहुत easy है इस industry को maintain करना. Less human capital चाहिए, but it requires some specialized knowledge. Now, what are those? The nature and the habits of bees, selection of suitable location for beekeeping, keeping beehives, catching and hiving of swarms, beehive management during different seasons, handling and collection of honey and bee wax. So these are the some aspects with respect to the technical aspects. So we have to follow all these things so that we can easily obtain a very good yields from the apiculture industry. Now here three figures are given. If we observe the beehive, in the beehive there are three types of insects are. One is a queen, it is a larger in size. Second is a drone, it is a male. Queen is a female, and apart from that, large number of worker bees are there, and these worker bees are sexually females. All worker bees are sexually females, which further divides into three categories. One category is army, which protect the beehive. One category is a nurses, which handle the caring of beehive. And third category, food collector, जो नेक्टर को कलेक्ट करके beehive में लेके आए. So तीन categories होते हैं worker bees के, और वो सारे sexually females. In each hive, only one queen bee is there. Apart from all, worker bees are there. And drones are only used for fertilization. That means after the development of drones, they will fertilize the some of the worker bees so that these fertile worker bees are now treated as a queen bees, and they migrate some other places and make their own beehives. So this is a management of bees. Now how they will communicate? The most important, the communication of honeybees. Honeybees ke bees communication डांस के थ्रू होता है. हनीबीज दो टाइप के डांस करते हैं, साइंटिस्ट ने उसको डांस ऐसा नाम दिया है. wagging dance and round dance. The communication of honeybees is because of the two different modes of dance patterns, wagging dance and round dance. ये पहली बार एक साइंटिस्ट ने डिस्कवर किया था कि the communication of honeybees is depend on the two types of dance. और साइंटिस्ट का नाम है कार्ल वॉन फ्रिच. कार्ल वॉन फ्रिच इस साइंटिस्ट को इस रिसर्च के लिए नोबेल प्राइज दिया गया है. नाउ द वेगिंग डांस एंड राउंड डांस एंड दिस टू पैटर्न्स आर बिकॉज ऑफ द मूवमेंट ऑफ अब्डोमेन. अब्डोमेन की मूवमेंट के हिसाब से इनको वेगिंग डांस और राउंड डांस ऐसा नाम दिया गया है. एंड दिस इज द मोस्ट efficient communication system of honeybees, and this discovery is made by Carl von Frisch, and because of that he was awarded with Nobel Prize. So this is about the apiculture, Apis dorsata, Apis floria, Apis mellifera, Apis indica. These are the most common species. Apis indica reared in India. Apart from India, Apis mellifera is used for rearing of honeybees. And then largest honeybee is Apis dorsata, and the little honeybee, that is smallest honeybee, is Apis floria. So this is about the apiculture. Now we'll move to the next, that is fisheries. Now fisheries is a most important industry which related to the aquaculture and pisciculture, right? We'll discuss about this. What is fishery? What is aquaculture? And what is pisciculture? Now here fisheries. It is a water body having fishes and other aquatic animals which are reared and caught for food, which is rich in proteins, vitamin A, D. Marine animals are also rich in iodine. Shark is rich in liver oil, and cod liver oil are very good source of vitamin A and D. So fisheries are mainly obtained for the fulfillment of food requirements of population. Now here two words are there, aquaculture and pisciculture. Now the aquaculture is a rearing of all the aquatic animals. Fishes, oysters, mussels, prawns, lobsters, some aquatic plants, etc. Everything is aquaculture. And the pisciculture is only restricted to the rearing, catching and management of fishes. So pisciculture is a part of aquaculture, and the industrial level production, the concept of industrial level production of these aquatic animals is called blue revolution, right? So there are two types of fisheries are there. Now in case of India has a large area of 16 million hectares under fresh water in the form of rivers, canals, irrigation channels, reservoirs, lakes, tanks, ponds and pools. 16 million hectares. It's a large area. And there are some important inland fisheries are there. Fishes which cultured in India, and prawns. Palemon and Macrobrachium. These are the two important species of prawns. Palemon and Macrobrachium. These two are prawns which belong to the fresh water. And the same thing, if present in the marine water, they called as shrimps. So prawns are fresh water and shrimps are present in the marine forms. Some fishes are given: Labio rohita, Rohu, Katla, Voligo oddu, Clarius batragus, it's a catfish, Mystis singhala, Heteroneustus. These are some of the most important fishes rearing in pisciculture within India. Okay, and apart from that, Palemon and Macrobrachium are the freshwater prawns. Now here some marine fishes are there. Hilsa, salmon fish, sardine fish, bombaden, that is harpedon, and pompref, stomatius. You can either remain a common name or you can go with the scientific name. It's okay. So Hilsa, salmon fish, sardine fish, Bombay duck, and pomfret. These are some marine fishes commonly used in India in aquaculture industries, right? So these are the some freshwater fishes and prawns, and these are some marine fishes. Now, there are two types of fisheries, are there? Capture fishery and culture fishery. Capture fishery and culture fishery. Now, what is capture fishery and culture fishery? Okay, so before going to that, here are some title. Now, the majorly fishery is divided into like this: inland fishery and marine fishery. Inland fishery refers to the fishing in the fresh water, called inland fishery. Fishery industry अगर fresh water में हो रही है तो उसको बोलते हैं inland fishery. जैसे rivers है, ponds है, और जो marine water में होता है उसको बोलते हैं marine fishery. So there are two types of this: inland fishery and marine fishery. So this is the based on source of the water, that is either fresh water or marine water. Inland and marine fish. लेकिन rearing के हिसाब से, natural और artificial, उसके हिसाब से देखे जाए तो दो टाइप के, culture fishery and capture fishery. Now what is capture fishery? Capture fishery means fishes को उनके natural sources से हमें पकड़ना है. That's called capture fishery. Whether it is inland or marine. Inland fishery में क्या होता है? We are using various number of different types of boats. इस boats के help से different types of nets are there. उस nets को और boats के use से हम पानी में जाते हैं, fresh water resources में, और वहां से हम net के through fishes को capture करते हैं. इसको बोलते हैं capture fishing. और अगर marine fishery है तो उसमें हम बड़े बड़े steamers में दूर दूर तक जाके समंदर के सारी मछलियों को लेके आए. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड मरीन फिश. बोथ आर कैप्चर्ड फिशरीज. सेकंड थिंग इज कल्चर्ड फिशरी. कल्चर्ड फिशरी में क्या होता है? दिस इज एन आर्टिफिशियल थिंग. मींस आर्टिफिशियली वी हैव टू मेक सम पॉन्ड्स. आर्टिफिशियली हमें पॉन्ड प्रिपेयर करना है, पानी डालना है, और उसमें हमें आर्टिफिशियल मेथड से फिशेस को कल्चर करना है. इसको बोलते हैं कल्चर फिशिंग. इफ वी डिपेंड ओनली इन द कैप्चर फिशरी तो हमें जो एक्चुअल रिक्वायरमेंट है, डिमांड है सप्लाई ऑफ फूड की, वो हम नहीं फुलफिल कर सकते, क्योंकि मानसून सीजन ही एक ऐसा सीजन है जिसमें हमें बहुत सारी मछलियां मिलती है. इफ वी डिपेंड ऑन ओनली नेचुरल मेथड, दैट इज कल्चर फिशिंग, सॉरी कैप्चर फिशिंग. बट टू फुलफिल द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ सप्लाई ऑफ ऑल दीज फिशेस थ्रू आउट द ईयर, वी हैव also depend on artificial methods, that is called culture fishery. So artificially we have to make different ponds and culture these fishes in that pond. This is called a culture fishery. Okay, so these are the two fisheries are there: culture fishery and capture fishery. Capture fishery is a practice of only catching the fish available naturally as in large water bodies like lake, reservoirs, tanks. And marine fishery also a capture fishery, that we have to collect the fishes from oceans. Culture fishery is the type of fishery found in small water bodies where fish is first reared and then harvested artificially. And the fishery industry is flourishing in our country and produce a large number of aquatic animals. That's called blue revolution. So two revolution hai. Ek hai milk production ka, jisko hum bolte white revolution, aur dusra hai blue revolution. White revolution, the father of white revolution, Vergis Kurien, और व्हाइट रेवोल्यूशन का मेन हॉटस्पॉट है आनंद अमूल फैक्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया विद इन द गुजरात इन द आनंद ओके सो दैट इज कॉल्ड व्हाइट रेवोल्यूशन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ मिल्क एंड दिस इज द ब्लू रेवोल्यूशन द इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ एक्वाटिक एनिमल्स टू फुलफिल द फूड रिक्वायरमेंट सो दिस इज अबाउट द टुडेज लेक्चर